2002-2003 brought fresh hope at Molineux. After a summer of reflection, was this to be the season that Wolves finally fulfilled their potential and reached the promised land of the Premier League? When the players reported back for pre-season, the message from Dave Jones couldn't have been clearer. Forget about last season, concentrate on the one in hand.
Well, first off was to get over the disappointments of last season and get the players back up and running. And same expectations as what we had last year was to try and achieve what we all want, which is Premiership status.
You know, we sat down throughout the summer and we knew what we had to do. We knew that we were looking to work at the top end of the table and we're looking to get promotion. So from day one when the players came back in, that has always been the aim of the staff, is to make sure that we prepare right, we create the right environment for the players to go and perform and to do well.
Expectations were naturally high and the players themselves were in confident mood.
Yeah, definitely so. We're very confident and we believe in one another. And we just can't wait to have that first game against Bradford and work from there and build confidence.
As preparations developed, Dave Jones bolstered his squad with the vastly experienced Dennis Irwin and Paul Ince from Manchester United and Middlesbrough respectively, as well as rising Icelandic star Ívar Ingimarsson.
Well, experienced players, but also good players, not just for their experience, because they are good players. And I thought they would bring something to the younger elements of our team, which you can't inject anybody with. You have to have gone through it, and their experiences of the clubs they've been at and games they've played in will rub off on the players that we had here and even senior players. But it wasn't just all about just getting them because I thought, oh, they're old players. And it was the impact that I felt they would have on the club.
Well, I knew that what had happened last year, I knew they were desperate to get up into Premiership up with the big boys. I was out of contract at United and I wanted to join a club that had ambition, and I seen this club as perfect for me, really.
With the pre-season fixtures drawing to a climax, a showdown against Premiership high flyers Newcastle United was the final tester for Dave Jones and his men. It wouldn't be the Geordies' only visit to Molineux this season.
We were pretty confident as if we had a good start, and hopefully we maintain the form that we had the previous season.
But it was time for the talking to end and the football to begin, kicking off with a trip to Bradford.
Nearly two decades have passed since Wolverhampton Wanderers were last in the top flight. Is it going to be their year? Well, you'll forgive the fans for not getting too carried away. They've heard it all before, and they know that Bradford City and 22 other clubs are going to be out to get them. Ashley Ward immediately looking for his strike partner, Katamari. It's away by the Wolves captain, Paul Butler. And he will stay captain, by the way, despite Paul Ince's arrival. Kearney. It was a lovely pass by Blake for Newton. Wolves are on the prowl. Irwin centre, Cameron, what a blast! Oh, and on the rebound from Alex Ray, it's trickled just wide.
A wonderful ball, good play here by Newton, but it's that ball that's whipped and he knew exactly what he was doing, Dennis Irwin. That's a really difficult one to catch, that Cameron. He's kept it down, got all the power he would want, an excellent save.
Layla's free kick. And Blake, and Miller! Oh, what a save from Gary Walsh to deny Kenny Milk.
Well, he made one in the first half. This one, reflex save from close range, tries to get the shot away there. Acrobatic, wasn't it?
Blake. And George Ndar, oh, he's through! George Ndar! And Gary Walsh got a vital, vital touch on that. City.
Not the perfect start, but Wolves know as well as anybody there are no guarantees in this division. Going into the first home game of the season against local rivals Walsall, 3 points were the only item on the agenda.
And it's Irwin who will take the throw. Looking for Newton, and he's got in as well. Ball is back for Cameron, who gives Wolves the lead. Irwin and Newton linking up down the right. And it was Newton who got the right side of the Walsall defender. Cameron was teed up into the back of the Walsall net. Newton into Blake. His strength is probably his biggest strength. That might just find his way through to Cameron. It's from a tight angle, and Wolves are 2-0 up. Second in the game for Colin Cameron, the Scottish international, from the tightest of angles, just about creeped in. Naylor. Miller, who was shrugged off the ball. And then a mistake by Butler. And the cross is in for Herivelto, who has pulled one back for Walsall. 2-1. Old-fashioned up and under from Paul Butler. It's Proudlock. He's managed to get some time and space for himself. It's a low cross. Evades the first player, but not the second, who was Sean Newton. And 5 minutes from time, Wolves have surely sealed 3 Molyneux points. It was Proudlock's cross, it was Sturridge at the near post, it was Sean Newton at the far post.
An important first victory, and Molyneux breathed a sigh of relief. It was a case of history repeating itself as Burnley visited Molyneux next.
Keeper won't get there. He's kept it in play though, which has given Wolves the advantage, and eventually cleared. Turn. Laid back to Cameron. Oh, the keeper's lost it. Blake will score. Only a minute gone at Molyneux. Nathan Blake scores the opener. A mistake from the goalkeeper. A comedy of errors, really. And that's a chance for Paul Ince to replace Colin Cameron. There is Wolverhampton Wanderers league debut. And a warm welcome as well. Alex Ray. Ince. Bustled from behind and then from the front. Welcome to the Nationwide League Division 1, it seems. Dennis Irwin over the ball. There's a four-man Burnley wall. There's a defender that's has been yo-yoing to her from the line. He's gone back there as well. Dennis Irwin. First goal for Wolves for Dennis Irwin. A well-placed free kick into the back of the net gives Wolves the second. Only minutes into the second half. Inge Marsen. Nice ball by Newton. Cooper will get there. Oh, that's a lovely finish. All in one movement. Kevin Cooper scores in the closing stages of the game. Clinches it for Wolves. It's 3-0. That was Newton's ball and some lovely skill here by Cooper to evade the one challenge and then touching it home with his left foot.
A more convincing performance, and for the second season running, the Wanderers strolled to a 3-0 victory over the Clarence. Because of international duties, Dave Jones's side had a 7-day break before their first ever visit to Derby's Pride Park.
Left-footed cross, back in by Sturridge. Helped on towards Alex Ray, who scores in front of the joyful travelling fans. Just 20 minutes gone. Ray's shot. He kicks, but he's found its way to Malcolm Christie just moments into the second half. Cooper, oh, he took a deflection, 2-1 to Wolves. It was a wicked deflection from Cooper's left-footed shot off Warren Barton. Back towards Alex Ray, his shot, oh, that's a fantastic goal from Alex Ray. Left footed, a good 20 to 30 yards out, and again the goalkeeper left with absolutely no chance. Blake decided to go himself. Cross in, it's going to be four, it is. Injury time from Kenny Miller, 4-1 to Wolves at Derby.
A superb victory and top spot in the table to celebrate. Following the defeat of the Rams, it was the Owls of Sheffield Wednesday that visited Molineux next.
Sean Newton. Ray is bustled off the ball. And Sheffield Wednesday are looking to break, and they do so. That's a lovely ball through to Shefki Kuchi. One-on-one with Oakes, and scores. Sheffield Wednesday take a shock lead at Molineux. Naylor taking the fight to Sheffield Wednesday. Off Leon Knight for a Wolves corner. We're on the hour marks. Sheffield Wednesday still holding on to that one goal advantage. As Naylor, the player who won the corner, elects to take it. Left footed. Lescott at the far post. It will fall back now to Newton. Lovely bit of skill. Time and space. Still numbers in the box. Blake is under it. Blake scores. 1-1. Lovely skill from Sean Newton, who got away down the right. Blake rose highest in the area. And there's plenty of options in there. And then Preston left to flood skin air. Second from Wolves. So Sheffield Wednesday are breaking. Leon Nice is making the good run down the right. He's got plenty of pace. He's sent in a first time cross, which Cucci is under with the header. And Cucci, just 2 minutes after Wolves equalised, has given Sheffield Wednesday the lead again. Ray bundled off the ball by Cucci. The two face up, but Ray just wants to get on with the game. Lescott with a right-footed cross, which is headed home by Deed Sturridge. Sheffield Wednesday held on to the lead for just 4 minutes, and Wolves have equalised on 68 minutes through the former Derby striker Deed Sturridge.
Wolves had twice come from behind. It was certainly a point gained on a frustrating evening. Going into the last game of the month, away to trouble Wimbledon, it didn't get any easier in front of a near-deserted Selhurst Park.
corner, which has been turned in by Neil Shipperley. The Wolves fans are silenced for the first time. Just 3 minutes in and Wimbledon are one goal to the gutter. Corner towards the far post, and in it goes. Flamingo Marson, first goal for Wolves. Not the prettiest, but certainly important. And Wolves back on level terms. And then switching play to the Wimbledon right. Two against two. Right-footed ball in. And it's turned in at the far post from Gale. The ball over the top, Ray. Only one option in the middle, and it was turned in by the Wimbledon defender. Dean Sturridge was piling the pressure on. But an own goal sees Wolves pull it back to 2-2. As though Butler was playing him on, and now Shipperley is all alone on the penalty spot and makes it 3-2. 15 minutes to go. Wolves will have to pull it back again if they're going to get anything from this game.
It had been a disappointing afternoon in South London as Wolves slumped to their first defeat of the season. But they lay fourth in the First Division, so it had been a good start for the club and had maybe proved a few points to the doubters.
When you've had the disappointment we had at the end of last year, you wonder how everything's going to start at the beginning of the next season. You know, some clubs who have missed out in their playoffs or the promotion period we had can have a dodgy start. But I think all in all, when we look back at August, it was possibly as good a start as we could hope for, just a slight disappointment at the end, but a nice steady beginning for the season. There were a lot of question marks over Molyneux, a lot of people outside this football club looking in, say how are they going to cope, how are they going to react to last season. And I thought, when you look back on it now, it was a pretty positive start from everybody. It's just the Wimbledon one that I think let us down, but a positive start from everybody, and it did suggest that perhaps all was not lost here.
Into September, Wolves were determined not to see a repeat of last season's early Worthington Cup exits, but Swansea offered a severe test.
To the right, Reid to the left. Five-man golden black ball awaits. It's left for Thomas, who curls it off the bar and in. Oakes is beaten. Swansea take the lead after just 7 minutes against the Nationwide Division One side. Sturridge, neat football. Again into the feet of Nathan Blake. Picks out Alex Ray. His body's start to gather in the box. Cross was in towards Blake, and Blake scores. Former Cardiff striker scores against Swansea, and Wolves pull it level. Helps it back to Ray, thunderous effort, great goal, 3-2 to Wolves with just over 10 minutes to play. Freestone and the defender on the line really stood no chance as Alex Ray rocketing that shot into the top corner.
the league programme resumed, Selhurst Park again proved an unhappy hunting ground.
And Oakes clears. Sent back with interest, helped on by Andy Johnson. This is Dougie Friedman. He's got Johnson to the right. He's found Danny Butterfield even here. Butterfield onto his more favoured right foot. Made its way through to Routledge, who shoots and scores for Crystal Palace. Just over 60 seconds have been played. The youngster for Crystal Palace has given them the lead against Wolves. Mullins. It's a poor pass by Friedman. Nice play by Sturridge. He's got himself one-on-one with Curtis Fleming. He's got Ingemarsson in support. And here is Ingemarsson. It's in. 1-1. It seemed to take an age to drop over the line. Super play from Dean Sturridge. The goalkeeper thought he'd done enough, but then it just looped in. Made four for Friedman. A simple goal. Question marks over the Wolves defending. Routledge. The ball goes one way. Naylor went the other. And now he's gifted it to Andy Johnson, who is brought down by Michael Oakes. And Crystal Palace will have a penalty kick. Friedman will take. And scores. Miller cuts in from the right, past Butterfield. First time ball in by Ince, receives it back. Saved by Kalinko, scored by Nathan Blake. Wolves with a lifeline. Mullins has peeled away and comes short. And in towards Thompson, it's a quick reply from Palace and the two-goal lead is restored.
A newly promoted Reading would give cause for more concern as the Wanderers slip to their first home defeat.
Hints to Sturridge. Here. It's George Undar. Lean Lainer. Teed it up, good save by Marcus Hanneman. It's a good play, and Irwin finding himself in a very advanced position. Newton looking for Irwin again. Ray. Should have meant it in. Certainly meant the shot, just over the bar. An assist from the back of Alex Ray.
Gareth Hansel, please contact the nearest student.
Lescott under the header. This is Hughes. Oh, tries one. Oh, and he's beaten Murray. And Reading are a goal up. Newton. Early cross. Oh, it's off the post from Sturridge. And the rebound from Newton is saved and forced wide.
With Preston North End visiting Molineux, having not lost since the opening day of the season, Dave Jones asked for a big performance from his boys.
Follett. Looking for Creswell. Lescott had done enough, but the ball is still in. And it was Broome's effort, which was cleared away by the foot of Matt Murray. Ray not letting anyone rest. And Blake has got clear. One-on-one with Lucas. 1-0 to Wolves. Blake peeling away from defence. It was a ball through by Alex Ray. Slipped under the body of the goalkeeper Lucas. Blake. Able to hold the ball up. Cross was in by Irwin. Lovely turn by Sturridge. Oh, that's a great goal. That's a well-worked goal and a well-deserved second for Wolves. Sturridge, the eventual scorer, but some lovely build-up play. And an even better turn from Dick Sturridge. Right-footed. Lucas again left groping thin air. Second opportunity, it sets Cooper away, and Blake 3-0, just 5 minutes from time. Nathan Blake's second of the game surely seals 3 points for the Wanderers. Ingemarsson to Ray. Ball over the top, Preston again, found wanted. This is Miller. He's got free, Kenny Miller, 4-0. All of the strikers getting on the score sheet. It's a late goal from Kenny Miller that makes it 4-0 to Wolves.
It was just the result that was needed as Wanderers hit four for the second time this season. But Wolves couldn't continue where they left off. Leicester beating them thanks to an early penalty and remaining unbeaten at home. So, after an impressive August, an indifferent September had seen Wolves slip from 4th to 10th in the table. But the message from Molineux was not to panic. It's a marathon, not a sprint.
We were getting used to using, we wanted to have two different formations to use, or variation on a theme, and the lads had still come to terms with that, and we used it a couple of times. And you know, we had some different performances through it, but you know, those things happen, and we were determined to keep working towards, well, the end part of the season. We know that you know, you are going to have spells in the season where things go really well for you and things don't go so well, and we were always determined to work through that and give the boys some options for when teams came and did certain things, that we were a bit more flexible than we were the season before. So I think September was we got a little bit of that. And that's why we probably saw the indifferent form through that month.
October began with the resumption of the Worthington Cup, but on a night of high drama at Millmore, Wolves made a nerve-tingling exit from the competition.
The win will take in front of the main core of the Rotherham supporters. Saved by Mike Pollitt. Really is sudden death now. John Mullin, chance to win it for Rotherham. And does so.
After the unfortunate Cup KO, there was no let up for Dave Jones's men, and the Blades showed much more cutting edge in front of goal than they did.
Page rushed into a clearance, which has landed back in possession of Wolves. Edworthy. Oh, a nice layoff. Falls for Ray. Has support on the left with Undart. Gets it across. It's an own goal. Wolves have taken the lead, and it's through Robert Ullathorpe. Sheffield United defender puts through his own goal. It was Undart's cross which caused the problems, and Blake was waiting behind just in case. And Love shot cannons away. Plenty of options in the box. It's found its way through to Michael Tonk. Oh, and it's in. It's hit Butler and it's gone in from Michael Tong. A driven cross, which is in by Wayne Allison. 5 minutes into the second half. Sheffield United 2-1 to the good. On it's there, Tong with the volley, 3-1.
It was Wolves' third defeat in a week and the club slipped down to 14th. But the message from within the camp was, have belief. Needing to get back to winning ways, Wolves saw Stoke away as being as good a time as any in front of the watching Sky cameras.
Nathan Blake.
We'll still have Dean Sturridge in reserve, of course, on the bench. Colin Cameron suddenly opens up for him. Took a deflection. But Cameron will claim it. He shows the way to goal, albeit in a roundabout way. Wolves are one up. You have to say they deserve this. They do deserve it. They've dominated proceedings in this second half. Blake fancies going for goal, and being a striker, he does fancy it, and that has put the seal on it for Wolverhampton Wanderers. Nathan Blake with virtually the last kick of the game. The Wolves are hungry again.
A much needed victory, and one to build on, with Colin Cameron making a welcome return from injury. With Grimsby visiting the Molyneux next, a win was expected, but an early scare would have to be overturned.
Naylor under it, Santos with the header to Cabot on his left foot. Oh, there's enough on it, and Grimsby are in front. Murray looked flat-footed as Cabot put it past him. Edworthy, time and space for Cameron. Links up with Ince, Cameron's shot. Ball, free kick for Wolves. Irwin, certainly favourite from this sort of range. It is Irwin. Oh, and it is a goal, and it's a delightful one as well. Over the wall and in. Danny Coyne standing no real chance with a quality free kick from Dennis Irwin. Santos with the header away, looped back in by Cameron. Wolves still have many bodies around. It's a strike from Ince, which is saved and turned in by Kenny Miller. It's a fantastic volley from Ince. Coyne stood no chance in holding it, and Kenny Miller, like all good strikers do, was there to follow up, quickest to react, and Wolves 2-1 up. Murray releasing Miller. Cameron. Blake has fed the ball through to George Undar. 3-1. Wolves are certainly in the driving seat now. I think Cameron was looking for the return himself. When he did find out where the ball had gone, Undar had got it. He's gone past Coyne and he put it in the back of the net. And he was off to celebrate. Taken short. Cameron's effort. A whisker away from making it four. Irwin. It's driven low and it's turned in the final seconds of the game by Dean Sturridge. 4-1 to Wolves.
After recording back-to-back wins following a dismal run of 5 defeats in 6, Wolves' message from Dave Jones was simple: keep it up. It was still early in the season, but the Wanderers had ground to make up, and a Tuesday night journey to Gillingham was their next test.
The half-hour mark in the first half. Colin Cameron, 1-0 to Wolves. No mistake from the spot. And that turns away. Blake wants it played early. Here is Nathan Blake. Round Brown scores for Wolves. It's 2-0. And celebrates in front of the mass hordes that have made the journey down from Wolverhampton. Links it with Cameron. And Miller, who was pulled out to the left. Supported again by Colin Cameron, whose low cross finds Nathan Blake, his second of the game. Wolves find themselves 3-0 up. Cameron playing it out wide. It's Blake. Turns neatly and gets it a shot, which Brown really should have done better with. Nathan Blake can celebrate a hat-trick.
Three goals for Nathan Blake and three wins in a row for the Wanderers. After struggling to find form early in the month, Wolves' 9 points from three games had lifted them back into eighth and provided some much-needed confidence.
3 wins out of three, yeah, it is a successful month, but we were struggling to find consistency and good players, and sometimes players have, you know, go through that. You don't want them to go through it, but it does happen. But we stayed firm in our beliefs and what we were trying to do. And it was a case of the players and the staff and everybody associated with the football side having to come through the bad run and learn from it, as we've always maintained, learn from your mistakes and everything else. So to get on a run of three games was important, because there's nothing better than you can give somebody confidence is all about winning games, and if you're losing games, then your confidence is dipped, as we well know. Well, I personally think Stoke was probably the turning point for us of this season, because Sky TV, full house, bit of a derby game for us, and we put on a good show, and plus we've got the likes of Colin Cameron back fit, which was a big plus for us as well, because the early part of the season we were missing players and influential players, and to get Colin back and give everybody in the team a big lift.
November began with a tough task away to Watford.
Cooper left footed through the wall. Good save by Alec Chamberlain. Midworthy. Away briefly by Neil Cox. Blake Ince. Oh, that's not far away. And Watford score through Cox. Direct from the corner. Dean Sturridge skips inside onto his right foot. Ray. With bodies in the middle for Edworthy. Not the best of crosses. Handball, no. Cooper, it's there. It won't be a penalty, because Wolves have scored through Kevin Cooper. A wicked deflection. All happened in the last few seconds of the game.
It was a welcome point when all three seemed to have been lost. Into the much anticipated clash against early pace setters Portsmouth at Molineux. And the question was, how would Dave Jones's men compare to the First Division big spenders?
Ray with a driven corner. Lescott going to get there. Nearly did from Miller, and saved again by Shaka Hislop. And then Alex Ray with a shot that really he should have crossed. Nice turn by Kwasi. Looking to take it on himself before he was fouled by Kevin Cooper. It's Merson. Oh, it's in. Murray left rooted. Merson away in celebration. Ince. Played into the feet of Sturridge. Sturridge again. Some good link-up play. Sturridge doing well. Keeps his feet and scores. Not only did he keep his feet, he kept his head just as good. And it was a cool finish for Wolves' equaliser.
A physical encounter, but there was little between the two teams on the evening, and the points were shared. An altogether different challenge awaited against bottom club Brighton, who were determined not to make a swift return to the second division.
Tamora's got away. Oh, that's a lovely finish. 1-0 to Brighton. Bobby Zamora with a delightful goal. Kennedy. Limited for options. He's found Mark Edworthy on the right. It's a ball in. Miller. It's there. The equaliser for Wolves. May have took a deflection. Miller will certainly claim it.
2 points dropped, but Wolves increased their unbeaten run since the home defeat against Sheffield United at the start of October. And into the Midland Derby away to Coventry, tensions were sure to be high.
Kennedy comes in, Wolves have got a player grounded for the time being. Here's Alex Ray. Onto his left foot, off the post, and the goalkeeper, Lescott, will score. Wolves have the lead. A rare goal from Julian Lescott. A thunderous effort from Ray, off the post as well as the goalkeeper. Lescott with the instincts of a striker following up. And looking for Sturridge down the left-hand side. He's got there and he's managed to keep the ball in play. Played back to Kennedy. Patrick managed to clear it. Alex Ray wants it. Oh, Alex Ray gets it. He was screaming at Andrews to move out the way, and then right-footed, belts the ball into the back of the net, and Wolves have a second.
The victory lifted Wolves back into the top six and continued their impressive run in a game of few clear-cut chances. Nottingham Forest were next to visit Molineux, and a full house anticipated a frantic encounter.
That's got away, Irwin. Unable to control, and all of a sudden Forrester getting numbers forward. This is Harewood, and it's Harewood who scores. 1-0 to Forrest. A mistake right on half time on the edge of the box by Lescott and Irwin. Andrews finding Dennis Irwin into Ray. Irwin happy to receive it back. His cross in, it's found Cooper. It's a good save by Darren Ward. Mistake there by Dawson. Now this is Miller. Still Miller. 1-1. Mistake by Michael Dawson. Jenny Miller has taken full advantage. Managed to get between Dawson and Des Walker to squeeze the shot past Darren Ward. Cooper. Edworthy. He's stopped in his tracks. Will be a Wolves free kick. And just 10 minutes remaining. The big guns will certainly be sent forward. Cooper is the man that's come across to take it. And it goes from Sturridge. It evaded Lescott and Sturridge in behind, 10 minutes to go. And celebrations all around Molineux as 3 points, three vital points may just be there for the taking. Cooper with an excellent free kick over the head of Lescott. Sturridge not going to miss from there.
The game ended Forest's impressive unbeaten run and extended Wolves' sequence to 8. But injuries were now a cause of concern as Dave Jones saw his side stretched. Before the last game of the month, away to Rotherham, Dave Jones resumed his search to fill the void created by injuries. And he brought the promising Carlton Cole in on loan from Chelsea to add to his attacking options.
Wolves did the double over Rotherham last season. But of course they were beaten in the Worthington Cup here on penalties. Kenny Miller now. Oh, he's gone for it.
Well, this is his real strength. Once they didn't win that first ball, he's onto it, Miller. And this is ability running at people. You don't know what he's going to do. He can go left, he can go right. decides to take the shot early. You can see he was aiming at that left-hand corner, wasn't too far away. So you have to whip them in with lots of pace, you know. Got to whip them in as low as you can as well to miss that first defender in there. No room for error.
Oh, Sturridge on the end of that. And nice try from Wolves. Always, always lively.
Well, it was a flat ball, wasn't it? Didn't look to be any danger. Makes a good run, Sturridge. Gets away, Branston, probably caught sleeping. But it was always going to be very difficult for him to be able to direct that into an area. But Pollock couldn't get to it.
Tracked by Garner and Monkhouse. Wolves still going though, and Ince looking for Sturridge. Ooh, free kick right on the edge of the D. Swales catching Sturridge, it seems. He has blasted in a couple of beauties for Wolves. Can he do it again? It's Dennis Irwin. Oh, and Follett's fingertips got to it. A mighty close call.
And so the points were shared in a less than entertaining match in front of the cameras. An unbeaten November had seen Wolves remain 8th. But for dropped points at Rotherham and at home to Brighton, it could have been a much more profitable end to an otherwise pleasing month.
Yeah, a few drawn games. If I remember rightly, at that stage we were trying to establish us one as being difficult to beat, two as getting an unbeaten run, because we're just coming off the back of a disappointing period. And as you say, we'd had three decent results prior to this month, but then it was a dig-in month, get the right results, keep ourselves right, and hopefully it can stand you in good stead right through. You're always disappointed when you drop points, and particularly to one or two clubs who obviously for us finish a little bit lower than ourselves, but in all, you look at them as points gained and you have to remain very positive. And eighth place was okay, but for Wolves it needed to improve, and we were looking to build on what we'd done to make sure that happened.
December dawned with a difficult clash as fourth place Norwich were the visitors, but on loan striker Carlton Cole would make a sudden impact.
Who went? Kennedy got enough on it, good save, made four for Cole, who scores! First goal for the loanee from Chelsea. Celebrated in style. It was Miller who got the final touch. Green got the touch. It fell for Carlton Cole. Played down the line. Cole making a nuisance of himself. Wins the throw. As though he was looking to take it himself as well. Irwin will take eventually, but surprisingly enough, it lands at the feet of Cole. Shrugs off the one challenge. And Ray into Cooper. Good save by Robert Green. That man Cole instrumental again in the move. Cooper with a good turn of feet. Left-footed shot, which was tipped over. Ray. Here's Cole, he's dropped deep and picked up possession, but he's sprinting forward now with some purpose. Lovely ball clip through to Miller. Another good save by Robert Green in the Norwich goal.
An important victory in the new month that got off to a flyer. Having faced the Wanderers only a few weeks earlier at Highfield Road, Coventry visited Molineux aiming to frustrate.
Partridge into Holdsworth. Partridge still wants it back, good interception, falls for Gary McAllister. Oh, that's a great goal from the Coventry player manager that gives Coventry the lead on 8 minutes. Into the feet of Dean Holdsworth, holds it up for Partridge, that's two.
In a traditional smash-and-grab manner, Coventry had stolen the points, and Wolves' 10-match unbeaten run had come to an abrupt end. Without the support of away fans, Millwall away presented a difficult fixture for Wolves.
Ray. Cole. Nice layoff to Mark Kennedy. Gets away down the left. They seem to have left him all alone. Mark Kennedy! scores a great goal against his old club. Just 5 minutes in, and Kennedy left all alone down the left. A left-footed shot over Warner. Great start for Wolves. Dennis Wiser sent it in. Murray away to Roberts. There's the equaliser. Scored by Roberts, created from Dennis Wise's corner. Undar goes to the left. Still Undar. Oh, it's only just wide. Former Crystal Palace man George Undar left Lawrence in his wake, but just couldn't quite turn the ball past Tony Warner.
And so the Wanderers had to be content with just a point ahead of the festive period. Boxing Day saw Wolves head north to face Burnley, where, incredibly, they had not lost since 1963.
Burnley on the attack at the moment, and it's Gareth Taylor, plays it through. Robbie Blake looks to turn. Two players in the box at the moment. Blake takes him on, crosses a ball, and it's a goal for Burnley! Gareth Taylor scores! Nice bit of play from Burnley.
Kennedy, inside. Ince, Sturridge, Weller. Saw that well, read it well. Just in between two players to Glenn Little. Westy, ever willing, comes outside of him to give the option. Dennis Irwin will keep close onto West. Gets the ball back from Blake, and a lovely one, too. And inside to West, but the referee lets the play on. Westy with the ball, deflection, yes! On the Wolves' right flank, we'll take it left-footed in swinger. 2, 4, 6, 7 players in the box. That's to the back post. Two Burnley players, it drops free. But luckily to Taylor, who can't get it clear. And he finds the back of the net, just turns inside. I'll tell you what it is, the hearts will start fluttering there. Innocuous sort of a shot. It's Butler who's come on a second-half substitution.
Paul Butler's goal was too little too late, and Wolves left empty-handed. So to the last match of the year, and Bradford City didn't bring any festive cheer to Molineux.
It's a call away down the left. He certainly got the legs, and then when it came to it, the finish was a poor one. Colin Cameron wanted it played into him. Reid, right-footed cross. Headed down to Jorgensen. Bradford have the lead. 5 minutes into the second half. But Wolves really do need to recover quickly from the going a goal behind. Certainly not deserved. They've been the better side, Wolves, so far. Here's Undar. Still on his left foot, Undar! And there is the deserved equaliser. Scored with a scorcher from George Undar. Bradford held the lead for a matter of 3 minutes before the reply from Wolves, which was from that left-footed strike from George Undar. To the left, Jorgensen. There's still three Bradford players in the middle, and there's an easy goal scored by Andy Gray. 5 minutes after Wolves' equaliser, they found themselves behind once again.
An afternoon of missed chances, and Wolves suffered their second defeat in a row. December had proved disappointing after starting so brightly, and it ended a year that had promised so much but achieved little. 2003, though, still had much to offer.
Well, it was because we felt we turned the corner in performance levels, as I said before, you know, from the Stoke game. And we'd had a good victory here against Norwich, I believe. But we were also lacking strikers. So all the good work we'd done, Paul thought we started to catch up. We seemed to hit a patch where we couldn't score goals, and that's very unusual for us. And again, trying to keep the confidence high and playing teams here, certainly at home, where we had the majority of the play and got caught by sucker punches was hard to take. But it was all about keeping the players' confidence and the morale high, and that never really sort of dipped in the dressing room. It was about keeping the chins up and keep going. And because we knew we were slowly starting to turn the corner, and we thought we'd done that, that we knew there was still a lot more to come from us. So it was just a case of keep going, really, during the month of December. But the points tally was disappointing for us, because we felt that we deserved more, but we didn't get it. I think sometimes when you go through a bad patch, the easy part for a manager is to just make all some changes for the sake of it. And then you lose all the continuity that you had, all the good work that you've been doing, you throw away, because then you lose your game plan and you've come off the road that you're trying to be on to achieve Premiership football. And then you throw it all away and it's like restarting again. And I didn't want to do that. So it was about everybody on the football side keeping the nerve and staying strong and believing what you were doing. And there was an awful lot written and said about this football club, what was supposed to be going on. But I knew, and my players knew what we were doing. And it was about just keeping your nerve and keep going.
The new year began with the visit of Derby, who had endured an unexpected fall from Premiership respectability. But they were unwilling to let the Wanderers have it all their own way.
Newton just about keeps it in. He's only got limited support coming forward. There's the cross, and it's a header wide by George Undar. Barton chases on. Murray not with the best of clearances. And there's an easy chance for Malcolm Christie if he can get there, and does, and Derby take the lead. A comedy of errors in the Wolves back four. 15 minutes in and Malcolm Christie scores. And Dar still going. Gets in the shot, which is well saved by Lee Grant. Still fall, it does, it's Paul Ince, the captain, with a fantastic strike to equalise the Wolves, just in the nick of time. Seemed to be held up for an age in and around the box. Ince was involved from the outset. That was Cameron's shot, but Dar in the way, Ince right-footing, grabbed, beat, and all ends up into the top corner.
Paul Ince's first goal for the club wasn't enough to prevent Wolves' winless sequence stretching to five games. But as attentions turned to the FA Cup, Dave Jones refused to acknowledge the underdog tag, and Molyneux was treated to an absolute cracker.
Kennedy, Wolves really have piled on the pressure in these opening few moments. It's a half clearance. Cameron laying it back to Butler, who gets it in. And Dart put enough pressure on to win the corner. Butler rises, manages to keep it in towards Ince, who scores. Wolves take the lead against the Premiership side Newcastle inside 6 minutes, and it's a well-deserved lead as well. Butler's header back from the short corner. Ince right-footed, did well to keep it down. Gibbons stood no chance. Irwin, it's a wicked cross and away by O'Brien. Kennedy able to turn. Cameron. Dash shrugged off it. Ince with a shot. Not far off from Ince. He's got that scoring feeling. Murray looking for the quick release and does so. It's Sean Newton. Supported now by Cameron, who's got forward well. It may just hold up for Kennedy, who's coming on and scores a second. Wolves are in dreamland in the FA Cup. 2-0 up against Newcastle. Kennedy left footed. He seemed to pass it into the back of the net. Genius. Out to Solano. And now Bellamy racing away from neatly. Naylor pulls it back for Shearer. And there for Genius, who scores. 5 minutes before the break, just what Newcastle needed. Bellamy into the box. The referee has given a penalty for the foul on Craig Bellamy by Jolene Lescott. Right on half time, Alan Shearer with the opportunity to make it 2-2. He does. All of a sudden, the dream or the bubble has been burst. Davizas. Nice touch by Shearer. Helped on by Bellamy. This is Acuna. Shrugged off the ball. Shearer will certainly be the favourite. Solano looks as though he's going to tee it up for the former England man. There is Shearer. Oh, well done by Lescott. And again, Jolene Lescott clears off the line twice in a matter of seconds when it looked odds on that Newcastle would score. The ball still in a dangerous position. And eventually, well, at the second attempt at least, it's landed nicely for Matt Murray. Kennedy. It's Griffin. And now Solano tracking the Irish winger. A low ball in. Miller eventually finding it at his feet. And Kennedy's cross. There's a slip and Newton and Undar. It's 3-2. Wolves are back in the lead. And the FA Cup dream is alive once more. Newton tenner down. Undar from 3 yards out. Couldn't miss.
Molyneux has witnessed many fine cup ties over the years. And this will surely go down as one of the finest. Back to the league and on a difficult surface at local rivals Walsall, Wolves overcame a potential banana skin.
Real up and under from Murray. Proudlock gets there. Right back to James Walker, who's missed it. It's going to go in, is it? It is now. George Undar with the finishing touch. An absolute nightmare for James Walker, the ball under his foot. I don't think it had gone in by that point, but Undar, well, he was never going to miss from there.
An important victory with George Undar proving to be the match winner once again. But Wimbledon would be the cause of much frustration as controversy clouded the result on their visit to Molyneux.
George Undar. It's a nice ball through. Good save from Kelvin Davis. It was Newton's shot. Wolves will win the corner. Naylor. Played away. Back with Lee Naylor once more. Finds Undar. 3 or 4 gold shirts in the box. That one's left for Cameron. Shot is blocked. Wimbledon eventually get it away, but it's only a brief respite because Irwin has sent it back in. This is Miller. Time to bring it down. Undar's cross. Wimbledon living on a knife edge at the moment. Still with Wolves. Mark Kennedy. Cross in. And this time it's in. Wolves eventually take the lead through Kenny Miller. Sustained pressure right on the stroke of half time. Miller's looping header over Kelvin Davis. And a well deserved lead for Wolves. Lee to Wood. May find through, it does. That's a thunderous finish from Damian Francis, and Wimbledon are level just after half time. Cameron, shot is blocked, but it's fallen nicely for a Wolves player. It's Kennedy, right-footed effort into the box. There's plenty in there, and Butler has scored for Wolves. But no, the players have surrounded the referee, and the fans as well, and Paul Butler are asking why.
It was certainly 2 points lost as the Dons celebrated and Wolves were left deflated. In the FA Cup, Wolves had been drawn against high-flying Leicester, and Molyneux was to witness another showpiece occasion.
Undar turns away from Elliott with apparent ease. George Undar with a fabulous goal, which gives Wolves the lead after just 5 minutes of this FA Cup tie. No one could keep up with him. There was two on him at the last effort. Walker stood no chance with a very cool finish from the Wolves frontman. Free kick taken quickly by Izzet. Dickoff being manhandled. It's going to be a penalty against Dennis Irwin. The foul on Paul Dickoff, and all of a sudden everyone is involved. Dickoff himself will take. Facing up to Murray in the Wolves goal, and scores for Leicester. 1-1. Davison penalised for the foul on Kenny Miller. Just on the stroke of half-time as well, so it would certainly be a good time for Wolves to get a second. It's Dennis Irwin, the number 8, who's over it. The usual suspects in the box. Butler, Lescott, Undar, they're all there. It is Undar, it is number 2! Right on half-time. Undar just can't stop scoring in the FA Cup. That's his second in this game. He scored one against Newcastle in the third round. Away by Callum Davison. George Undar. Away from Alan Rogers. Slipped it through to Miller. Super run. Super finish. Super goal for Wolves. It's 3. In the FA Cup, the fifth round is just round the corner. Miller getting the right side of the Leicester defender, going round Ian Walker and slipping that one into the back of the net to the jubilation of the Molyneux faithful. Newton. Miller wants it. Here is Kenny Miller. Saved by Walker, but it's only a respite because there's number 4. Wolves are 4-1 up with 20 minutes to go in the FA Cup fourth round. Ian Walker will certainly be to blame for a poor first save.
Into the fifth round they marched after another afternoon of cup drama. An unbeaten start to the year had ensured a steady climb up the table to 8th, while FA Cup fever certainly had a firm grip of the club.
As I say, the turning point for me was the Walsall away game, where we could easily have slipped up and gone, oh well, we did well last week against Premiership clubs, and then fallen away the week after, but they didn't. They stuck at it on an awful surface and got 3 points, and I think that gave them added belief in the league that they could go to places like that and pick up points. Yeah, I think, as you say, we kicked on from there. I think those two results gave us everything. The Newcastle game gave us belief that we could do something in the cup. And also the league form we picked up, and we had belief then that we could grind out the results when we needed to, and we could play our football and get results that way too. So it gave them a tougher inner core to go out and win matches, and a steady rise then. We started to pick up points and that gives you the belief, and then you look at the league and you have a good performance and you actually move up a couple of places, another good performance, move up another couple of places, and the lads just, we're on a bit of a run here. And again, that breeds the confidence, that breeds the belief amongst the lads and amongst the staff and the, and everything starts to, you know, probably gel a bit more. And you know, the lads took that on, and hopefully, you know, end on a good note.
As the league fixtures resumed in February, a visit to struggling Sheffield Wednesday offered the chance for Wolves to continue their rich vein of form.
This is Montgomery-Miller, the ball through here is good, it's Proudlock, he's done it, he's scored against the club that he was with only a couple of weeks ago. What an irony here. Sheffield Wednesday's defenders were all looking for offside, the flag was not raised, Mr. Winter looked to his assistants, Proudlock went on and beat Kevin Pressman, and it's 1-0 to Wolves. There's a bit of a delay there, put Robinson under pressure, so Wolves will win the ball back, and they four up against four here. It's Paul Ince's ball, problems here for Wednesday, it has to be two, would you believe it? 2-0 and two goals for Adam Proudlock. Well, that's devastating to Sheffield Wednesday, but they dallied and allowed Paul Ince to play the ball through. Kennedy squared it, and Proudlock coming in could not miss. Ince marshalling things in midfield. Proudlock held it up, but Wednesday still emerged with the ball. And another mistake there by Westwood, that's a couple he's committed in recent moments. There might be a third goal here, there is! And Kenny Miller has squeezed a header behind Kevin Pressman. Wednesday trail 3-0 to Wolves. It was an Ashley Westwood lapse out on the touchline, and the cross came in there from Mark Kennedy, and flinging himself into the header was the Scott Miller, and Pressman unable to prevent the ball wriggling over the line. And Wednesday looked like being scoreless for the first time in several weeks. He's onside, it's Sturridge, it's still Dean Sturridge, but the move has petered out perhaps. Oh, it hasn't, it's in the net, it's four, it took a deflection, and Dean Sturridge has added to Sheffield Wednesday's humiliation. Just when it seemed as though that move had fizzled out, Dean Sturridge managed to get in a shot, it took a slight deflection, which bamboozled Kevin Pressman. It's Wednesday nil, Wolves four.
Another four-goal demolition and one to savour for the returning Adam Proudlock. But the old Brighton curse struck yet again in the Wanderers' first ever visit to the Withdean Stadium, making it one to forget.
Kennedy with the quick throw. Ray. Wolves need more bodies in the box. There's the cross, there's Kenny Miller has pulled one back. It's 3-1. To Brighton. Certainly a well-worked goal. Ray out to Kennedy. There was only Miller to aim for, so it was certainly a good cross, and Miller diving amongst the feet to score.
Back to Molineux and back to the FA Cup, and third division Rochdale would prove harder than expected.
As though Lee Naylor will take. Left-footed, floated into the area. Drops to Cameron. Here's Irwin. Ince laying it off to Newton. This is blocked by Griffiths. There's claims of a handball. Either way, Wolves have got a corner. This is the Rochdale captain Griffiths came across. Didn't look like it hit his arm. Kennedy will take. It's driven low, it's found its way to George Undar. It's in the back of the net, Wolves have the lead. Hard look on the young Rochdale goalkeeper Jilks. Beaten, possibly by a deflection on the way through. Evans into Platt, former Walsall striker Clyde Platt. Evans again with a crunching challenge. Here's Paul Simpson. Has a shot from range which looks as though it's taken a deflection in front of Murray. The third division side have made it 1-1. Cameron gets it in, but it's away from Evans. Naylor Shot is saved by Jilks. A hint of offside as Miller turns it home. 2-1 to Wolves. The cup dream is alive once more. But certainly a hint of offside as Naylor's shot came through. It was less got it looked as though it hit. It could have off Jilks had made the save. But Miller was there to turn it home. Kevlar keeping the ball. And Wolves coming forward in the closing stages of the game. Here's Cameron, saved by Jilks, but turned home by Adam Proudlock in the closing stages of the cup quarter-final. And that will take them through to the quarter-final, Adam Proudlock.
All the way, Wolves had come through a stiff test to earn a quarter-final place. At Ipswich, who had enjoyed a resurgence in form under Joe Royal, Wolves then won a thrilling encounter on a bitter night in Suffolk.
Bent down to Fabian Wilmers, long ball for Darren Bent to chase. Lee Naylor with him. Here now Marcus Bent, changed the game in the second half against Sheffield United when he came on his sub. Marcus Bent just held up there by the challenge of Julian Lescott. Lescott has conceded the free kick here for the challenge on Marcus Bent. Chance to get the likes of McGreal forward. Garzo's in there as well. In by Ambrose, Murray was stretching, and Ipswich Town have the dream start. Andy Marshall now will clear for Ipswich Town. There's Julian Lescott, on towards Georgian Dart. Magilton. Lescott, still. And he looks for Ndar's head, finds him. Now Colin Cameron! Marshall's lost it, and Wolves are level. It's Kenny Miller, 13 goals for the season now for Kenny Miller. Another shot from range from Colin Cameron, was too hot to handle for Marshall, and there was Kenny Miller, Wolves' top scorer, to punish him. As we enter first half stoppage time, 1-1 the score, and Tito can score! Paul Ince. Murray looked to return the ball there to Kenny Miller. This now is Mark Kennedy. Kennedy's cross towards Kenny Miller, 2-2! Fantastic flowing move from Wolverhampton Wanderers, finished by Kenny Miller. Played in so well, and there was Miller. Good finish, good goal all round, 2-2. 2-2 the score then, Kennedy's corner, Ince arriving, away by Wilness. Lee Naylor might volley, Lee Naylor, what a goal! He simply caught hold and scores a special, special goal. Kennedy's corner was cleared by Wilness and full on the volley, Lee Naylor let fly. One of the goals at Portman Road this season from Wolves' Lee Naylor. Proudlock for Colin Cameron, and onside is Georgian Dart, and Dart can seal it away from the goalkeeper. Georgian Dart makes it 4 for Wolves. He sprung the offside trap and sends the travelling Wolves fans into delirium. A through ball picked out Ndar's run, no flag against the Wolves striker, around Andy Marshall, and he finds the net. 4-2 Wolves lead now.
After twice coming from behind, Wolves were well pleased with their night's work, which pushed them back into the playoff zone. And away again, this time to Craig Brown's Preston North End, informed strikers George Endara and Kenny Miller ensured a comfortable double over the Lancashire side.
Well, Butler will marshal him. Had to turn back towards his own goal. Neat interchange of play before Butler gets himself in the way of the ball, and now Georgian Dart picking it up into the Preston half, and still going Georgian Dart. He's got three or four around him. Dart, what a goal! What a fantastic goal from Wolves' Georgian Dart. He picked that up from the edge of his own 18-yard box. He's run and run, unchallenged for most part, and then a left-footed strike has given Wolves the lead. Undar racing away to the right. Neat support. Gets it through Ray. And now Paul Ince. Andrews chips the ball over the top. Nice ball as well. Miller gets onto. First time effort. Over the bar of David Lucas. Undar gifted the ball. Finds Miller with space. Onto his right foot. Over the bar again from the Scottish international. Irwin. Away by Lachetti. Irwin again. This time feeds the ball through. Crosses into Kenny Miller, who 7 minutes from time can eventually celebrate a goal. Proudlock with the cross, well worked, good pass by Dennis Irwin, which opened up the space. And from then on, Proudlock with a good cross, and Miller was never going to miss.
It was the Wanderers' eighth victory on the road and kept up their promotion challenge. But Watford's defence would prove harder to bypass on a frustrating evening.
Helped on by Nielsen. Eventually Ince brings it down. Alex Ray, helped on by Undar to Cameron. Chamberlain saving again, and then a good challenge denying Mark Kennedy. Scottish international Cameron who will take. Decent cross as well. Lescott though will have to stretch to get there. Claims of a handball and pretty much justified as well. Certainly worth seeing again. Well, the hand was used. I suppose how deliberate it was would be up to the referee. Irwin looking for options, gets one from Undar. Not the best of passes back to Dennis Irwin. Wolves though still do have possession, and it's switched by Andrews here now to Mark Kennedy. Into the box, Kennedy right footed. Oh, that was nearly the one.
And so for the first time this season, Molineux witnessed a goalless draw. It had still been a successful month. Three wins had lifted Wolves back into the playoff places, and a quarter-final spot in the FA Cup was also theirs.
Yeah, we'd had a disappointing Christmas time, and then it improved just into New Year, and then it was time to push on because we couldn't afford any further slip-ups there. We were losing a bit of track with the top two, Leicester and Portsmouth, and we knew we needed to sort of stick things on really strong if we were going to make ourselves any sort of force to be reckoned with. So it was a decent month to follow on from January, and I think the confidence then was beginning to build and people were looking good. People were beginning to believe a little bit as well, which I think was really important. Yeah, fantastic. You know, it added a great spice to the season going further in the FA Cup. And I think that, again, helped. The run in the FA Cup certainly rebounded on our league form in general. And I think that they both went hand in hand together. So getting further and further in the FA Cup was a major boost too. But I think as we came through the months, we saw the emergence of people like Kenny Miller getting his goals. Paul Ince began to get stronger. Paul Butler had come back into the side after being out for something like 12, 13 games and looked strong and fit and well. Matt Murray had established himself in the team throughout the season. So there was a good feel, as I say. People were now beginning to display their talents and their abilities on a more consistent basis. And that was the feel that was saying, OK, we've got to keep working at this. And from our point of view, as I say, from the coaching staff, was to say, keep the focus right for the players. There's a lot of things that can get distracted about here at Molineux, but I think the players responded well on the pitch. And that was our priority, to make sure that was the case.
Crystal Palace were the first team to visit the Molineux in March, with Wolves eager to make amends for their September defeat.
Robinson nearly nipping in. He's received it back. Proudlock. Newton again. And it's found its way through to Adam Proudlock. There's two waiting. Falls to Kennedy. And then Wolves are in the lead through Kenny Miller. Proudlock the creator. It's crossed. A bit too much on it, but Kennedy did well for the reason he snapped at the shot and pulled it back. Leaves it to Kenny Miller. The ultimate striker scores for Wolves. Acres of space here on the left. He's picked out by Colin Cameron. Short ball back to Lee Naylor. Nice skill by the Wolves player. Into the box, Naylor receives it back. Still Naylor. Oh, very close. Some good skill from Lee Naylor. Got himself into the box with a neat 1-2. It was Miller who he linked up with. And then just as though he put it the right side of the post, it creeped the other. Powell's ball upfield. Now Kennedy. Going past Powell, it's a low cross. And there's the second. Sturridge scores it. Kennedy once more the creator. He's run across. Pinpoint for Sturridge. The defender or goalkeeper were ever going to stop it. Goes he lone and scores a cracker. 3-0 to Wolves, it's Kenny Miller's second goal of the game. His 11th goal in the last 9 starts. Wolves slowly seeing 3 points and a fantastic finish from their Scottish international, Kenny Miller. By Kennedy, and he's got there. Powell has pulled Kennedy back. Surely it is a penalty. And straight away, all eyes look to Kenny Miller, who will certainly take the penalty to seal a hat trick. Dennis Irwin has allowed Kenny Miller the chance to seal a hat trick. Last kick of the game, and does. 4-0 to Wolves. Kenny Miller has got 3 of them. 3 valuable points are in the bag. Just can't stop winning these days, and Miller can't stop scoring.
It was now 12 goals in 9 for Scottish international Kenny Miller, and 5 matches without defeat for his team. A quick second meeting between Wolves and Ipswich appeared to be heading towards the same outcome as the first, but a late goal ensured the points would this time be shared.
Looking to counter-attack just as quickly. Naylor is shrugged off the ball by Lescott. Nice turn by Kennedy. There's plenty of space if he can pick out the pass, which he does to Blake. Powerful shot, which is just wide of the Ipswich goal. Irwin. Able to look up and pick out his pass. This is Ince in a forward position. And a great goal by Paul Ince gives Wolves the lead after a pretty poor first half. Eventually we have a goal, and scored by the skipper Paul Ince. Yeah, Scott. across Bowditch. Gives Ipswich a chance to get some of their big guns forward. It's in towards Naylor. It's there. 1-1. A late equaliser at Molineux. Richard Naylor, the goal scorer.
As attentions once again turned to the FA Cup, Wolves paid their first visit to the St Mary's Stadium for a quarter-final clash with the Saints. It was a big day for Wolves former Southampton manager Dave Jones.
Spencer to take. BT with the flick on. Marsden. It's in. It's creeped in. Chris Marsden will claim it. I think the bodies in front of Murray made the ball go in the net. Crossing, which evades BT, comes off Butler. It's a cruel, cruel blow for Wolves.
That's where the cup story ended. Promotion was now the only target. Wolves were immediately thrust back into league action at fellow promotion challengers Reading.
Miller. Well saved by Hanneman. Kennedy. Miller. Denied again by the American goalkeeper. Kennedy over Miller. Oh, nearly from under, maybe now. It's there, Kenny Miller. Eventually Wolves take the lead. Off the post, and for the first time, the American goalkeeper, Marcus Hanneman, is beaten. It's Newton's cross. It's another cracking save by the inspired American goalkeeper. Oh, good save by Murray.
Another test passed. The team showed no evidence of any cup hangover. After outplaying leaders Portsmouth earlier in the season, Wolves had no reason to fear a trip to Fratton Park. But an injury-stricken side were beaten by an early goal in a scrappy game.
Todorov. Rebounded nicely for Steve Stowe. Made his way forward. Oh, it's gone in. Off the top of Murray.
Local rival Stoke had only one aim at Molineux as they battled to avoid the drop.
They await Irwin's corner. Knocked on towards Kennedy. Off the line. May fall. Proudlock couldn't get his shot in. And then Lescott acrobatically tries to keep it in play, still in and around the Stoke box. Eventually it's cleared up to the halfway line. Naylor is under it. Uses his unaccustomed right foot to get it forward. Still plenty of options. This is Colin Cameron. He's going to try from range. That was only just wide of the Stoke City goal. It remains goalless, but only just.
It was just one of those evenings as Wolves failed to break through a packed defence. After scoring just once in four, Wolves bounced back in style. They hit top form against Andy Hesenthaler's Gillingham.
Butler, Nathan Blake, 1-0. 15 gone, Nathan Blake. Grabs the opener. After a link up with, of all people, Paul Butler on the edge of the box. And a cool finish to end it. Naylor to Kennedy. Oh, that's a lovely skill. There's left Southall trying to catch up with him. Kennedy's cross, though, not the best. Falls to Cameron. Oh, that's a tremendous goal. Wolves find the second. Some delightful skill out wide from Mark Kennedy. But an even better finish from Colin Cameron on the volley into the back of the net to give Wolves a 2-0 lead over Gillingham. For Mark Kennedy, some woeful defending by Gillingham. Mark Kennedy there to take full advantage. and that's 3-0 to Wolves. It, but Miller's going to get it through the middle, one-on-one with Bartram, 4-0, right on the stroke of half-time. Great ball from Paul Ince, he had two options, Blake was the other, Miller central to goal, beats Bartram, all ends up. Miller didn't get there, but Wolves are coming forward. Miller still with Blake, it's a save by Bartram. Kennedy, second of the game for Mark Kennedy. 5-0 before half-time. The former Wolves goalkeeper Vince Bartram, an unorthodox save to say the least. It fell to Kennedy, time and space, steadied himself, and that's in the back of the net for number five. What will the second half bring? From deep, and then Miller in no man's land really as he goes through. Can he make it 6? He does. Just 3 minutes into the second half, 6-0 to Wolves, second in the game for Kenny Miller. How many could this end up?
It was 6 of the best from Dave Jones's team, who thrashed the Gills for the second time this season. March may have seen the end to the FA Cup dream, but with the league the priority, Wanderers seem to be hitting form at just the right time.
Out of the FA Cup, a little disappointed with that because of the manner we went out. We know we felt we could have done better on the day. But if you look at the league form and the performances we gave in the league, they were very much up to scratch. And with a bit more luck, you can pinch another couple of points. But that's football, you know. That football does do that to you. You know, when you play well, you may not get your rewards. May play different and get your reward. So as long as you stay focused, as long as you're working hard, then things will even itself out and you get what we deserve. Apart from, I think it was Brighton away where we did really underperform, where we just wasn't good enough, we wasn't up to scratch at all. They've been hitting the ground, they've been getting the right results, and they've been breeding that confidence, breeding that belief, and everything had gone on and snowballed, and we played some big games and come through those games, and we felt that we were hitting the form and hitting, you know, the right type of form and the right type of belief at the right time of the season.
April began with a visit of Rotherham United, who had held Wolves to a goalless draw early in the season and would do so again as the Wanderers battled against the odds.
That's a nice skill. Blake gets himself away from two Rotherham defenders. Good save low down. The goalkeeper Mike Pollitt. It's left for Irwin off the top of the two-man wall. And then a flick which was from Newton. Asking Pollitt to work once more, tipping it over the bar. Quickly by Alex Rep. Out wide to Newton. He's got Dennis Irwin on the overlapping run. Still Newton. In fact, Sturridge was brought down. Talbot was the offender. A penalty to Wolves. Colin Cameron. Saved by Pollitt. The rebound was from Sturridge and Pollitt has saved that as well. Not to be for Wolves.
A familiar test awaited at Grimsby, who were desperate to sustain their first division status. But there would be no room for sympathy from the Molyneux men.
Danny Coyne's kick towards Campbell. John McDermott searching for Mansaram's run. Paul Groves is there, sends it back down towards young Mansaram. Good skill by him. Ooh, almost away. Those long, lanky legs not quite getting the better of the defence. Good ball, great ball. Here we go again. Straight through Danny Coyne's legs. Well, it was a great ball by Kenny Miller. and it bisected Danny Coyne on his 6-yard area.
The one goal proved enough, and three priceless points lifted the Wanderers up to fifth. In an exciting Friday night encounter with playoff candidates Nottingham Forest, a victory seemed there for the taking.
Oh, and Blakey's onside. He's got the right side of Dawson, and he's put the ball in the right side of the net. Wolves 1-0 up. Blake playing on the shoulder of Dawson, and the young defender will certainly be to blame as Blake's got through. The finish unquestionable. Beaten Ward, and Wolves have the lead very early on, just 10 minutes gone at the City Ground. An important goal as well. Blake doing well to get there before Reid. This is Cameron, has taken it down well. That's a fabulous finish. Wolves find themselves 2-0 to the good at the City Ground. It was a long ball. Blake did very well to get there just before Reid, and then the ball over the top. One touch from Cameron to control it, the other to put the ball into the back of the net past Darren Ward. Wolves 2-0 up. He's done well to evade all three Wolves challenges. Still coming forward, Reid into Johnson, who's onside. There's a goal back for Nottingham Forest. David Johnson, their leading scorer, gets it. And a lifeline. Shimika over it. There's plenty of movement for him to aim for. Goes in towards Johnson. Murray's lost it. It's in. It's given. It's Dawson. Dawson will claim it. It's 2-2 after Wolves were 2-0 up.
But the Wolves had to be satisfied with just a point. As Millwall visited Molineux next, it was to be an unhappy return for ex-Wanderers manager Mark McGee.
Miller, Cameron wants it. All alone, Colin Cameron. Round Warner, off the line. Newton, will he get there? Yes, 1-0. Five minutes in, good play by Colin Cameron, just about cleared off the line. Newton, not used to using the left foot, but he took a swing. They beat Tony Warner. Wolves in the lead. Warner not looking too pleased with the kick. You can see why, because Wolves have possession. It's with Dennis Irwin. Helped on by Undartu. Cameron, he's done it all himself. Oh, a fantastic finish, makes it 2-0. The second goal has took its time in coming. Just over 10 minutes remaining. But it certainly was worth the wait. Cameron doing it all himself. And a finish over the top of Warner to surely clinch 3 points for the Wolves. No need to rush, they've got that second goal. Just 10 minutes remaining. Newton, they may not need to rush because the third is on the cards. A lovely, lovely finish from Sean Newton. Second goal in the game. Races away in celebration. 2 goals in 2 minutes at the end of the game. 3 goals and surely now 3 points.
A comfortable victory inspired by the outstanding form of Colin Cameron in the heart of midfield. Into the Bank Holiday Monday fixture at Norwich, with playoff qualification high on the agenda for both teams.
Touch gets there just before Kenny Miller. Now coming forward. Nice ball through to Wundar. May have done enough. He has. George Wundar celebrates a goal for Wolves. Robert Green could only get a hand to it. Mackay was just shrugged aside. Wundar with a good finish. Low pass Robert Green to give Wolves a valuable away lead. Kennedy. Sturridge, 2-0. The trademark celebration from the Wolves 29. and it was another well-worked move. Kennedy out on the left. You can't afford to give him the time to get the crosses in, and Sturridge given time and space to head the ball past Robert Green for Wolves' second. Wolves taking the time in the final seconds of the game. Here's Kennedy to Miller. That will seal it. 3-0. Kenny Miller wheels away in celebration. Another 3 points are going the way of the Wolves.
And so the Wanderers booked their place in the end-of-season playoffs in scintillating fashion. But who would finish where? That was the question as Wolves went into their final away game of the league season at Sheffield United.
Lescott closed down by Pesky Solido, who's got cleared of Lescott. Murray has come out and Pesky Solido has chipped him. It's 1-0 to Sheffield United, and the scorer is the former West Brom and Birmingham striker. Pesky Solido beaten to it by Alex Ray. Kennedy had to move quickly. Here's Sturridge, and now George Undar, who certainly will move quickly. And there is the equaliser through the legs of Paddy Kenny. Undar with a cool head at just the right time. Pesky Solido with Cabot, has come shoulder to shoulder with Lescott. That will be a penalty kick. Lescott penalised for the push on Steve Cabot. Michael Brown gives Sheffield United the lead once more. That will surely be a penalty at the other end as Cameron goes down. It was a foul by Robert Page. Dean Sturridge. Little shimmy sends Paddy Kenny the wrong way. And Wolves can celebrate once more. Good ball through, Pesky Solido. It's there!
Wolves had been deprived of all 3 points by the late strike. But it wouldn't be the last time these two teams would meet this spring. For the third month this season, the Wolves had remained unbeaten, and with a playoff place confirmed, confidence was high going into May.
We felt we were getting stronger, physically and mentally as well, which was important. And over the season, we've had injuries to strikers and midfield players and defenders, and through no fault of their own, they've had a rest. They had a break from the game, and maybe just coming into the last throes of the season now, them injuries that they had or breakaway they had from the game are standing them in good stead now. And we didn't get that the previous season, because basically come the end we were running on empty tanks. Now we seem to be running on full tanks. I think everybody's working hard and everybody's trying to stay focused, and as one of the players said to me the other day, we're in a zone at the moment and we don't want to come out of it.
Already promoted Leicester visit Molineux for the final league game of the season, with both teams eager to bow out on a high.
Long kick from the former England goalkeeper. Polley's header. It's Newton. Helps it on towards Kenny Miller. Goes past Taggart with ease. He's got players in support, but Miller will go alone, and a lovely finish right at the end. Into the bottom corner past Walker. There's two or three Leicester defenders trying to keep up. He's left them for dead at the halfway line. And Wolves take the lead on the hour. Is it? Opening on towards Tommy Wright. Up against Polley. Wright goes past him, and he did use his hands. Ludovic Polley is penalised for the use of the hands. Right at the death, it's a penalty to Leicester. Trevor Benjamin will take. Up against Matt Murray in the Wolves' goal. Benjamin scores for Leicester. It's a late equaliser at Molineux.
So the points were shared and the Wanderers headed into the playoffs fully aware of the job in hand.
It's sort of the reverse from the year before. We started off strong last year, 2 years ago, and this year we started slow and built up, and we've got stronger and stronger as the year's gone on.
Well, obviously we're very confident. We've played all the teams now. We've played all the teams that are in the playoffs, played them twice, and we've had some good results against those teams. And so you have to be confident. You go in there and you back the squad that you have. You work with them. Well, I've certainly worked with this team for a year now. I know the players over a number of years. And you know, we'll be anything other than being confident in what we can do would be wrong. And the players have proved, certainly over the second half of the season, that we've no reason to fear anybody going into the playoffs.
It's a 4-team tournament, and if you can play well over that period of time, hopefully you get 3 games out of it, and we can play well. Then I think you get the little breaks that go with that. You don't very often, over a little tournament like that, play poorly and get the breaks. So we're looking to maintain the form that we've shown in previous months and previous games and take that into playoff areas and see where it takes us.
No, our target is to get the Premiership, and that's what we're all striving for.
Only 3 matches now stood between Wolves and the Premiership, and the first was at home to Reading in the playoff semi-finals opening leg.
And Dart gets it in on his left foot. Blake holding it up for Cameron, who's coming on, saved by Marcus Hanneman. And it's a quick clearance. All the way through to his opposite number, Murray. Harper. Out to Shorey. Little wanted it played through. He's got it as well, the Burnley midfielder. On loan to Reading. Here's Shorey again. He's got past Lundar. Gets in the cross. Found his way through to Nicky Forster. Reading take first blood in the playoffs at Molyneux, with a goal from the former Birmingham striker, Nicky Forster. Williams and Blake to Welsh internationals. Kennedy gets in a low cross, which will be cut out easily by Harper. Has time to look up, but then Kennedy closes him down. Clearance as far as Cameron. No one unable to control. It's Chadwick, the latest Reading player to lose out, to Mark Kennedy, looking to go himself. There's the cross, it evades everyone apart from Miller. Good save from Hedeman. Blake. Williams misjudged the ball. It gives Undar a chance to shoot. Tipped wide by Hanneman once more, who is the scourge of Wolves at the moment. Lundar on that face from left foot. Harper looking to go by himself. Pathlescott, good challenge from the Wolves number 5. And has time to steady himself and pick out the pass. This is Newton. Supported by Kenny Miller, pulling out to the right. Now Dennis Irwin. Again, Wolves chucking bodies forward as the cross comes in. Again, it's in and around the box. Pause for Ince. Claims of a penalty by Brown, but then he goes in anyway. And Wolves have equalised 15 minutes from time. In the playoff semi-final first leg, Newton struck the shot, may have took a deflection on the way through, claims of a penalty in there as well. None of this lot will mind, it's 1-1 and Wolves are back in the game. That was Miller's ball forward, that was I think the claim for handball. This was a claim for a penalty when Ince was fouled by Brown, and then the ball fell nicely for Newton, right footed into the back of the net. It's 1-1 in the playoffs. Sure, 1-1 would suit Reddy. Here's Naylor. Nicely laid off to Miller. Gets in a shot. That man's there again in the Reading goal. Good turning shot from the Scottish international Miller. It's taken by Sean Newton, and a chance for Butler, which he's put wide, and the whole of the Black Country, or half of it at least, have their head in their hands. Blake does well, brings Paul Linton into the equation. Cameron. Miller has come short. It's come across to Ince, who has the time and space. Fouled at the last moment by Brown. It'll be a free kick in a very dangerous position for Wolves. The usual suspects are over it. Naylor, Irwin is in there as well. Naylor strikes it. It's there. 2-1. Wolves have an advantage to go into the second leg with. 5 minutes of normal time to play. Not the best free kick that Lee Naylor has ever struck, but it's found its way through to the back of the net. And Reading, after taking the lead so early, find themselves 2-1 down at the tail end of the first leg.
They had left it late, but Wolves had a precious lead. Just 90 minutes away from a Cardiff final, and discipline and focus were the words flying around the Molineux camp as they headed into the return leg at the Medeski Stadium.
Here's Kennedy. Now Miller. Cameron. Good turn by Miller. Slipped through to Blake. And he pulled back towards Sean Newton, and Sidwell got back. Put in towards Brown. Oh, it's a good header. Good reactions from the goalkeeper. There's Kennedy away. Nathan Blake. Steered through towards Kennedy. It's a good challenge there by Harper. Miller. Newton. Cameron's got into a great position if they can find him, and they have! And Colin Cameron is stopped by a great challenge. AD Williams coming across at just the right moment. Ray. We're into the last 10 minutes now. You can imagine the Wolves fans looking at their watch more than they're looking at the pitch at the moment. Irwin. Cameron. Blake. Good turn by Ray. Alex Ray, the substitute, scores the goal that surely takes Wolves to a Cardiff final.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt about that. And doesn't he do well to fashion a chance? Because he doesn't have too much to aim at in the beginning, but he makes it for himself, Alex Ray. Look at this, he's just gets his ball from Cameron here. There he is, turns around. AD Williams is with him. Can you get close to the ball? Once he drags the shot across, AD Williams puts his foot across. We've seen so many goals where balls go through players, defenders' legs. There's another one. The goalkeeper can only stand and watch, and then the reaction when it goes through the legs is too late.
Murty. Harper. Now Hughes. The checks on the watch now by the referee.
And Wolves make it to the playoff final. They may now be as little as 90 minutes away from ending 19 years of hurt outside the top flight. Ray, the substitute sent on by Dave Jones, suddenly got the break and delivered the goods.
Next stop, the Millennium Stadium, where the Wanderers would battle it out with Neil Warnock's Sheffield United for that coveted place in the Premiership. As preparations continued, Wolves set up base in South Wales ahead of what was arguably the club's biggest game for decades.
Oh, we've just done what we've normally done. We've worked hard in the training. We've gone through our set plays. 48 games we've worked for to get here, so everybody knows what's expected of them, what jobs they've got to do. Done it for 48 games, and now we've just got to do it for this final one.
As throngs of Dave Jones's Golden Black
suddenly got the break and delivered the goods.
Next stop, the Millennium Stadium, where the Wanderers would battle it out with Neil Warnock's Sheffield United for that coveted place in the Premiership. As preparations continued, Wolves set up base in South Wales ahead of what was arguably the club's biggest game for decades.
Oh, we've just done what we've normally done. We've worked hard in the training. We've gone through our set plays. 48 games we've worked for to get here. So everybody knows what's expected of them, what jobs they've got to do. We've done it for 48 games and now we've just got to do it for this final one.
Throngs of Dave Jones's Golden Black Army descended upon Cardiff. It would be a day to remember in the Welsh capital.
One place left in the Premiership. The final fixture of the English domestic football season. Frighteningly high stakes. I wonder, Jim Beglin, which of these two sides is better equipped for this afternoon and what may lie beyond them?
Well, thanks, Peter, for that, because it's not an easy call. I mean, my head's telling me Sheffield United, and yet my gut instinct is for Wolves. But both sides have shown fabulous character just to get this far. I hope it lives up to its billing.
The outstanding players on show today will be Michael Brown, though he has run into traffic early in the shape of Cameron. And now Kenny Miller's had an early pop, providing a comfortable early touch for Paddy Kenny. High from Irwin, chasing back his Page. Miller beat him to it and lined it up for Blake! Big, big opening.
Well, Sheffield United should have dealt with that better. They shouldn't have let the ball bounce to begin with. It's too easy for Kenny Miller to get onto it. He shows good strength, the feeder to Blake, and he should have hit the target. Gets it nicely onto his left foot. He really should have been steering that inside the post. Keeper had to work. What a great early chance.
So many human interest stories surround this final, and of course David Jones is representative of one of those, what he has been through. There's a great groundswell of opinion that he deserves his chance back in the Premiership. Blake's flip, Miller's chase, Jagielka backpedalling, came to Kennedy! Wolves are flying! Mark Kennedy with the purest, zippiest hit you would ever see. And it's all old goal.
Well, again, I think Sheffield United could have been more decisive. That's a couple of times the ball's come long in the air and they haven't dealt with it. Good flick on by Blake. And Kennedy was so well fed. The difference between Nathan Blake before is he made sure it was going to be on target. You can maybe question Paddy Kenny as to whether he could have guarded the post a little better. Miller does ever so well. But what about that for a strike and a start for Wolves?
Untied by Julian Lescott. Well won by Blake and well pursued by Cameron. Away from Jagielka, Cameron! That's a very good save. Good strong top hand at the expense of a corner. Kennedy with that corner, Ince with the header, 2-0, Nathan Blake! Wolverhampton Wanderers have clear daylight. And have a glimpse, just have a glimpse of the Premiership. Nathan Blake, Cardiff-born, in Cardiff.
To be honest, I think for me this illustrates Wolves' sharpness in attack. They've been that little bit quicker to everything when they've got in their end, the Sheffield United box, as opposed to the other end. Ince just ahead. And all Blake has to do after it came his way is just to help it on. There's enough pace on it. Wasn't a clean header by Ince, but still went in the right place. And now they really are up against it.
Page. Cabba on the turn. Naylor labouring to stay with him. Cabba has such power when he gets up ahead of steam. Tong. Neat feet from Tong. And still. And now Cabba. And a brilliant save by Murray to salvage Paul Ince, because the skipper's header was goal-bound.
And Murray was on his way to the far post. Michael Tong's looking for a penalty for this. I don't think there's anything in that. But what a reaction that is. They were tentative at the back early on. That certainly cost them. And I think they've been one-dimensional going forward. They're a better side than what they're showing today. And Wolves, for me, are looking comfortable.
Cameron, Blake, on one for Newton. Miller waiting in the middle. Sean Newton for Wolves to have a three-goal lead at the break. They have a three-goal lead at the break. It is Kenny Miller. They can reach out and touch it.
The Premiership is very, very nearly theirs, and it isn't half-time yet.
And that's been the difference. Every time Wolves have attacked Sheffield United, they've looked dangerous. I mean, again, this is too simple. It's too easy. Look at the oceans of space Newton has. All the time in the world to look up. It's not the most immaculate of touches from Kenny Miller. It doesn't matter. It was good enough to find the back of the net. And again, it's a soft goal from a defensive viewpoint. Wolves, I think they'll be pinching themselves in the dressing room at half-time. What a scoreline this is at the break.
Cosworth. Aimed at Asaba, out by Lesker. Comes down for Brown. Nicked in for Tung. Turned wide for Love. Asaba goes in for it. Steve Bennett's seen an arm. And he's given a penalty. The most innocuous seeming moment. Paul Butler is the offending defender, and you're bound to say he did everything he could to take his arms out of the way. That is some decision, but it offers Sheffield United and Michael Brown a lifeline. And Murray has saved it! And the follow-up is over as well. And you're tempted to say that justice is done. You are also tempted to remark, not for the first time on the afternoon, as Sheffield United folk continue to go into mourning, that here is a Premiership goalkeeper in the making. The man whose heart has been broken so often. For him, this is the day. A glance at the watch. McCall. All in a lost cause now for the poor beaten Blades, who've given so much to this season. Kozluk lifting it in. Lescott away. And Wolves' tortuous journey to hell and back is over at last. And why wouldn't you smile for Dave Jones, who himself has made a personal journey to hell and back? And why wouldn't you smile for those in old gold who have carried the weight of history, that burdensome weight which is now lifted from their shoulders on the home ground of Nathan Blake internationally. Blake, who scored one of their three first half goals in front of their extraordinary support. And their thoroughly decent manager finally has his just desserts. And a year ago, the hurt of those fans was as close as any sporting hurt comes to being insufferable. That spirit-sapping collapse, allowing West Bromwich Albion in. Well, now it's Wolves who can glance smugly down from the upward escalator to see the baggies disappearing beneath them. And it is Sir Jack Haywood's day, perhaps above all others. Just a wonderful personal moment for him. And now the governor, the man who's won so much before. Twice a champion of England, twice a cup winner, the League Cup, the Cup Winners' Cup. Now something new. This time it is another silver trophy that awaits him. The trophy may be silver, but today all that sparkles is old gold. Wolves, grand old Wolverhampton Wanderers are in the Premiership.
Remember the day, after 19 years, 13 days, 22 hours and 50 minutes, the Wolves were back where they belong.
It's been all worthwhile, and we're back in the Premier League, where we, as we say, where we belong, and it's all been worthwhile and we've got an hour to stay there.
Do you know, being a chief executive and, you know, a suit in football, people always think that all we want to talk about is the money side of it. But I actually think that that question is probably the most important, because that is really what it's all about. It's welcoming David Beckham and Manchester United to Old Trafford, Thierry Henry and Arsenal, Alan Shearer and Newcastle United, week in, week out. And we are going to develop our club now, because more and more young people are going to want to watch us. And I think this whole thing bodes very well for the future. We're a big, big club. We know that from the demand of for tickets that we had this week. Fantastic.
You know, it speaks for itself. And you saw what it meant to all the fans and that afterwards. And everyone associated with the club, it's just a great day.
As tens of thousands lined the streets and filled the stadium, it was a true hero's welcome for the Molineux men. A fitting way to end a quite remarkable season.
The bus ride was just amazing. You know, tens of thousands of people on the streets of Wolverhampton come out specifically to, you know, show their congratulations to the team. We really are overwhelmed. We're the Premier League, boys. Here we come.
So, out of years of darkness cometh light, and Premiership football will be gracing Molineux in 2003-2004. We'll see you there.